Thank you. Please remain standing for the singing of our national anthem by graduating student Sierra Wan, accompanied by Mr. Tinsley.
First, I'm pleased to greet the greetings from Archbishop Michael Mulholland. Dear graduates, I am pleased to have the opportunity to bring greetings to the graduates and their families on this very special occasion. This year tested the fortitude and strength of many of us. It is important to recognize the achievements and joy found in persevering through challenging times together. The challenges of living in the present moment can be so consuming that we may cease to be aware of how interconnected our lives are and that we are all part of one exceptional story, the story of salvation. The love we share with each other through kind words, acts of charity, and advocacy for social justice, locally and globally, help to forge the bonds of unity. These bonds are part of the foundation of our lives as followers of Jesus Christ. Throughout the history of Catholic education at Holy Cross, the presence of the Holy Spirit has accompanied generations of students, families, and staff who have opened their hearts to live out their unique roles. We can be confident that God's grace is abundant, and regardless of how difficult some of our present moments have been this year, the fruits of gratitude, charity, peace, joy, and love abound. This year's pastoral theme, Beloved Children of God, was hopefully for many of you a time to reflect on one of the greatest mysteries. See what love the Father has given us that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. The first letter of John. At the beginning of his ministry as the Bishop of Rome, Pope Benedict said, "Only when we meet the living God in Christ do we know what life is. We are not some casual and meaningless product of evolution. Each of us is the result of the thought of God. Each of us is willed. Each of us is loved. Each of us is necessary." In other words, each one of us are intricately valuable and have a direct, distinct purpose to fulfill in this life. As you take time this summer to enjoy the company of friends and family, I encourage you to rejoice in God's goodness and trust that you are his beloved children, living out your unique pathway to holiness at this moment in time. May God bless you and keep you always in his tender care. With prayerful best wishes, I remain sincerely yours in Christ, Michael J. Mulhall, Archbishop of Kingston. I invite you please to remain seated. Let us pray. Almighty God, in many ways today is like any other. The sun has risen, the winds have blown, rain sometimes falls. Today people are born and laugh and cry. Today is like other days, for it is your gift, as it always has been since you created day and night. And so it will be until you bring all things to an end. Today is also fresh and new, like no other day. Today is a day of passage to a new beginning for these graduates and for their parents, siblings, grandparents, and friends who have gathered here. But today is also new, and so today we pray for all those who have met the challenge of these past years and have kept the faith and commitment to their studies. And now we offer thanks for the success of their journey. We thank you for granting them focus and direction, new strength and endurance. You created the knowledge and understanding they have mastered. You have created the curiosity and capacity and determination that led them in their pursuit. All of these good things come from you, and for this we give you thanks. Although today is new and today is different, we also pray for tomorrow. For this graduation opens another door to another time. And as you have led in the past, lead now into the future. Give them the focus and clarity and a calling from you to understand your purpose for them, and give them the courage to respond and step forward to that purpose. To you, Almighty God, be glory and praise forever and ever, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Good evening. Tonight we celebrate the academic achievement of our 249 graduates. I'm Jenny Mello-Jordan. My co-host for this evening will be Mr. David Orser, and we will be your guides through tonight's program. Welcome to this, our 34th annual commencement exercise, and our first in-person graduation since 2019. I, for one, never thought I would be so excited to be back breathing in other people's contaminated droplets. I'm extra excited tonight because this evening is Holy Cross's first ever super spreader event. I mean, if you don't count semi-formal, and no one does. The good news is that our numbers have dropped significantly since we stopped testing everyone, making tonight possible. Seriously, though, I know that many of you may be nervous about being in this crowd here tonight. You may have concerns about your safety, and I get that, so I want to help alleviate some of your worries by telling you that I will not be making any G.I. Jane jokes this evening. But if at any point I do accidentally offend your wife, I want to let you know that unlike Chris Rock, who seems to have no self-preservation instincts whatsoever, if I see you coming for me, I will run for it. I know you're summing up the situation and you think you'll be able to catch me, and normally you would be right. However, one, I only have to run as far as the closest human shield. Ma'am, you'll do well if you don't mind. I'll let you know if I need your services later. And two, you thought we packed you in here like sardines due to space issues. But no, that was in fact for my safety. By the time you shimmy down the aisle that you chose, I will certainly be able to get away. But we don't have to worry about any of that tonight, because tonight is about celebrating you, graduates. We take this time to reflect on the journey that has brought our students to where they are today, to say goodbye and to look to the future. This, for the last 2 years, was done through a combination of walkthrough and virtual graduations. But not this year. You will be the first graduates in 3 years who get to hear your names and walk across the stage to receive your diplomas. And before you get too excited about that, I want to remind you that unlike those who attended virtual ceremonies, you will not be able to fast forward through the speeches. Not that they would have, like I'm sure they would have watched. And unlike when you attended classes virtually, you will not be able to turn off your camera, mute your mic, and go have a nap. for this evening, you will have to be present, and not present like you were in class when I could see your initials on the screen, but you never actually engaged in the breakout room or answered that one quiz. The numbers have been finalized, the calculations are complete. There have been no mistakes. Tonight you will graduate, which is no small feat. And I can say that, having taught several of you this year. This is usually the point of the night when I comment on how much the graduates have been through in the last 4 years. I talk about the struggles that they've had to overcome and how they've persevered through tough times. And to be honest, usually I don't really mean it. I mean, I guess they had to really have a difficult biology test or something, but you guys, not since the graduating class of 1945 has there been a better story of perseverance than yours. Seriously, the biggest natural disaster that your parents ever lived through was Ice Storm 98. We didn't go to school for a week, and most of us didn't lose cable. Just kidding, my family couldn't afford cable. But my VCR kept eating my VHS copy of Jerry Maguire, and it was super inconvenient. There was no expectation that we would do schoolwork from home in 1998. Think Kojiko was slow? Try doing remote lessons using dial-up. Oh, wait, some of you did. Shout out to Napanin. You had one normal year of high school, and normal is not usually how people describe the grade 9 year. You've missed out on so much of what makes high school great. While managing the endless back and forth of in-person and virtual classes, the movement from semesters to octos to quads, and when we are finally back to precedent times, you will have time to reflect on the last 4 years. And someday, when you finally get a chance to sit down with your children and your grandchildren and talk about what you've endured, no one will believe you. No one will believe that you washed your groceries before bringing them into the house, or that you left your packages to quarantine in the garage before bringing them inside. No one will believe that there's a lineup to get into stores, that carts and hands had to be sanitized, that we had something called social bubbles, that COVID tests were given out in schools and liquor stores, or that vaccine passports caused controversy. No one will believe that you were forced to continue classes virtually while distracted by your teacher's odd choice of home decor, unless, of course, they chose to change their background and to be floating in space, in which case you were distracted by trying to figure out what they were trying to hide behind that. No one will believe that delicious buttery bagels were targeted as an evil source of contamination, that group work was outlawed, or that your teachers were instructed to sit you in rows because COVID could only move in a straightforward line. No one will believe that you did your math tests illegally using the equation solver and still only got a 75. That your mom got a worse mark on the essay she did for you than the one you did for yourself. Or that in 2020 you only completed the first unit test and your teacher still had to give you the credit. No one will believe that you had to wear masks while playing basketball and volleyball or getting your teeth cleaned at the dentist. That singing happy birthday was illegal, or that the Prime Minister uttered the words, "Speak moistly," on national television. No, no one will believe you, but you should probably remember that the next time you roll your eyes at your parents and grandparents when they tell you that they walked uphill both ways to school to get back to in the snow. That could be true. You don't know. You don't even go to school when there's a risk of a flurry. Got through the last 2 years without feeling your pain. See, the thing parents don't tell you is that they like it when you're not home. Seriously, every minute you're not home, they're checking off another life skill they're hoping to teach you. And with friends, social skills, check. Playing sports, healthy active lifestyle, check. Studying for a big test, hard work and focus on academics, check, check. Mandatory volunteer hours, concern for others, check. Or maybe completing necessary but unpleasant tasks, depending on what you're doing. Either way, check. Working productive member of society, check. Also, let's face it, every minute you're out of the house is another minute you're not eating everything in the kitchen, asking for money, leaving cupboards open, messing up the clean areas, creating more laundry, and interrupting alone time. Big check. So when you were disappointed that you had forced to stay home, so were they. You see, these were the people who gave you every ounce of love and support and encouragement your entire life. They cheered at your sporting events, even if you had no athletic ability. They watched you sing off-key at every school concert, edited your nearly illiterate essays, endured your mind-numbing TikToks, and pretended to care when you endlessly droned on about Minecraft. And they were happy to do it, because soon you would be leaving. Now they had to endure you talking about how tortured you were to be stuck in the house with them for any length of time. Not only that, they were also stuck. And now they had to explain why Harry Styles is playing loudly in the background of all their work Zoom calls. They had to share their workspace with someone who regularly gets S's in organization. And God help them if they had to listen in on any of your lessons. Sorry about that, parents, we weren't at our best. It really is no wonder why some of them would risk a $5,000 fine just to get you out of the house. And not at our best was putting it nicely. No one was more excited to return to in-person lessons than your teachers. We loved seeing you each day and feeding off your energy as you progress through academics, extracurriculars, and as you grow with you as people. Most of us taught remotely while having to endure our own children's lessons. At the same time, in the same house, using the same Wi-Fi. For some of us, that meant hearing every topic be taught through song. Baby Shark was a welcome reprieve from the morning math reps, which may explain the record profits of the LCBO during that time. We also missed extracurriculars. 2020 was the first football season that Mr. Pendergast has missed since 1978. Many coaches continue to hone their skills and coach throughout the pandemic, of course. Their houseplants and spouses were much less receptive to the lessons, no super awkward for the neighbors. Many teachers took up hobbies and learned new skills. Some learned a new language or to play a musical instrument, others a craft. And at least one learned how to use his work email without hitting reply all. We could not be more thrilled that your final year of high school had as much normal as we could possibly give you, which is why we are so happy to be here with you tonight. So without further ado, it is my pleasure to present you with your salutatorian, Santiago Pimentel.
Let me just take a sip of water before I get started. They say hydration is key. Good evening, Reverend Father, honored guests, members of the board, administration, faculty, parents and family, and of course, the graduates. Salutations, one and all. I guess I won't be confused with my twin brother again after today. My name is Santiago, and it is truly an honor and a privilege to be standing before you today. We must cherish this moment and be thankful to God for the opportunity to be gathered together in person. Thank you, everyone, for joining us in this momentous celebration. To our families, I would like to say that your love and support has made an enormous impact. We would not be here without your many sacrifices. Thank you for always being there when we needed you the most. I would also like to thank the Holy Cross Administration for leading our school community and making this year a remarkable success. We all appreciate each of the hardworking individuals who made this graduation ceremony possible today. Our teachers have done their best to prepare us for our post-secondary lives, and they deserve recognition. We would not have made it through high school without your guidance and knowledge that you have graciously imparted upon us. As your students, each of us has sincere gratitude for your support during challenging times. I think we can all agree these last few years have been an uphill climb, but here we are now at the summit. Many positive, uplifting, and amazing events return this year, such as the athletics competitions, the Arts Alive Showcase, and our successful Carnival Day. The innovation of our teachers, and in particular, Ms. McDonald and the Student Council, made these events possible. Thank you. I would also like to thank our chaplain, Mr. Kotman, for our beautiful graduation day mass this morning. EAs, guidance counselors, and every other adult in this building Your kindness and your presence have been like a warm light to us. This year, our board theme is Beloved Children of God. When I reflect on the past year, I recall the important fundraisers in our school community, as well as the mental health initiatives where we exemplify how Jesus would have lived, being of service. Service teaches us to look beyond ourselves for a while, to remind us that others also face difficulties in life. To my beloved friends, the Holy Cross Class of 2022, I will miss you, and the memories we have made in these halls will be treasured for the rest of our lives. But be warned, you might get a call from me in the near future when I need to borrow money for university. Thank you for motivating each other and pushing on forward. Everyone here has the potential to do remarkable things, but our future depends on the choices we make today and the people we surround ourselves with. I hope we never lose sight of that, so that we can continue to succeed together. Thank you for your time and congratulations, Class of 2022.
Share with you this evening. My biggest fear standing up after listening to the opening remarks is that you would refer to me as the superintendent of COVID. So many thanks for not pointing that out. Reverend Father, special guests, graduates, family, friends, and staff, it is my distinct pleasure on behalf of the Algonquin and Lakeshore Catholic District School Board senior team to bring greetings and congratulate the Holy Cross graduating class of 2022. As a family member, a friend, clergy, or educator, we've all played a part in God's plan to nurture and develop the talents and gifts of each of these graduates. You have worked very hard, graduates, so enjoy this evening. Remember to thank your family and staff for the support they have given to you to achieve these goals. Graduation fosters excitement, but sometimes brings fears as well. I would like to share a poem, Footprints, with you. It always comforts me when I face change, and it goes like this. One night I had a dream. I dreamed I was walking along the beach with the Lord, and across the sky flashed scenes from my life. For each scene, I noticed two sets of footprints in the sand. One belonged to me and the other to the Lord. I noticed that many times along the path of my life, there was only one set of footprints. This really bothered me, and I questioned the Lord about it. Lord, you said that once I decided to follow you, you would walk with me all the way. But I have noticed that during some of the most troublesome times in my life, there was only one set of footprints. I don't understand why in times when I needed you the most, you should leave me. The Lord replied, my precious, precious child, I love you, and I would never, never leave you during the times of trial and suffering. When I saw only one set of footprints, it was then that I carried you. So graduates, as you venture out beyond the doors of Holy Cross Catholic Secondary School, be courageous and find comfort in the fact that God is always with you. Remember to treat everyone you meet with respect, and God bless. Thank you.
Here to bring congratulations on behalf of our Board of Trustees, Assistant of Chief Medical Officer of Health of Ontario, just kidding, made the part up, Miss Patty Turkington.
Before I begin my greetings, thanks for the promotion. Good evening, Father Hibbert, Ms. Daniels, staff, honored guests, graduates, and families. The The Board of Trustees is so pleased to extend our heartfelt congratulations to you as you reach this milestone in your academic career. We are painfully aware of how difficult the past few years have been. Without minimizing the efforts of those who have helped you to get to this place tonight, there is one unexpected and valuable lesson that the global pandemic has taught you, and that is the need for kindness. The changes you endured, like online learning, the loss of school events and activities, changes to cohorts and timetables, and having to wear a mask to keep you and others safe, were just some of the things that made school a very different place. Each of you has quickly learned that a small gesture, a smile, check-ins were as important to you as they were to others. Caring for others in God's creation is one of the mandates of the Catholic education. And never has a class graduated with more firsthand experience than that than you. Congratulations on completing your high school diploma. Congratulations on your resilience and rolling with the punches. Congratulations on learning some of the most important lessons you will ever need to know. Take care and God bless.
Up next, Vice President of the 1 p.m. Press Conference Fan Club, your principal, Mr. Ian. I need my reading glasses. Father Hibbert, Superintendent Smith Dewey, Trustee Turkington, staff, guests, family, friends, and graduates. Welcome to the Holy Cross graduation celebration of 2022. What a gift to be here in person. Well, graduates, here we are. Here you are, surrounded by your family and friends, marking a singular achievement. Graduation is often referred to as a solemn occasion. Mostly, I think it's hoped you pause for a moment to take stock, to appreciate all that has happened in the rather large gulf between your entry to high school as scraggly, doe-eyed grade nines and this early adult milestone you're marking tonight. Has grade nine ever seemed both so recent and so far away? St. Catherine Siena tells us that nothing great is ever achieved without enduring much. Well, you have all certainly endured a lot. Yet remember, please, that working in harmony, anything is possible. Please take some time tonight to thank your loved ones who have helped you thus far in your journey. This year, as you've heard, our pastoral theme, Beloved Children of God, sits within the board's mission statement to build faith-filled learning communities where each member is loved, inspired, and successful. I hope that over the past 4 years, disruptions notwithstanding, you have found a place to shine in the classroom, in clubs, math competitions, in the arts, tech, faith-based service, or athletic endeavors. Getting to see a little bit of each of your talents has been a true pleasure. An esteemed educational researcher, Richard Stiggins, challenges teachers to make learning goals clear. In so doing, he postulates that students can hit any target that holds still for them. I hope your teachers and EAs have held up your learning targets like flexible, shiny beacons. And I know you've hit these targets and many more right out of the park. High school walk-off grand slams that in some cases could never have been expected. You surpass our expectations in ways far too varied to list here. Probably, being human, we haven't always made those targets clear enough or fine-tuned enough for you at times. You are likely to face moving targets again in your future. And in such cases, we hope you trust in your skill set, your resiliency, and above all else, in God's loving plan for you to help you make the choices that will mark each of you Holy Cross Catholic Secondary School graduates as caring contributors to our world.
go forth in the world, be good, do good, and remember your roots. Bring that sense of Holy Cross family with you. As many have remarked in one way or another, don't look back, for you're not going that way. But know that we are here, reveling in your journey. God bless you, Holy Cross Class of 2022.
We have a special tradition at Holy Cross at the first school mass of the year. Grade 9 students and students new to the school receive a small wooden cross that signifies their membership to the Holy Cross community. Upon graduating, these same students will receive a silver cross, which represents their membership into the greater church community. These crosses, which were blessed at Mass earlier today, will be presented to the grads with their diplomas. All graduating students will be photographed receiving their diplomas. These images will be emailed to graduates on the share drive. You, of course, are more than welcome to take photos as well. The best vantage point is at the center aisle, since your child will, at some point, walk straight towards you. As a reminder, your children are lined up in alphabetical order by last name. Therefore, if your child's last name begins with S, there is no need for you to stand in the center aisle beginning at A. There is nothing as vicious as a mother preparing to update a profile pic. If you get in the shot, she'll take you down. Stay safe, come up when it's time. As a courtesy to others, we ask that you wait until all graduates have received their diplomas before making your applause. You see, clapping and hooting takes time, but more practically creates heat. So remember, each untimely hoot is getting us all a little closer to finding out who buys their deodorant from the all-natural health food store. What I'm saying is, you might want to have a good look around before making your decision to holler. Choose wisely. I will let you know when the moment comes to hoot. Graduates, when you come forward, please take the steps to my left. Receive the diploma first. Feel free to smile or grimace at Mr. Janeko. It will be right there. Grimace. And then receive your cross. Going in this order will ensure that there's a lovely photo of you receiving your diploma and may prevent the need for your parents to crowd surf as they come down the bleachers. You will then proceed down the ramp, wait for your parents' profile pic. Our second photog will be in the middle of the aisle there. Give another wave to them and then return to your seat. Ben, you're the only one that really matters here, buddy. If you do it wrong, we're all going to. Got it, up the stairs, smile, go. Ladies and gentlemen, the presentation of the Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Subject Awards for Highest Academic Standing, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Specialist High Skills Major in Information and Communication Technology Red Seal Diploma, Specialist High Skills Major in Environment Red Seal Diploma, the Crusader Certificates, and the Holy Cross School Letter. To begin, graduating teacher Mr. Robin Watts will read the names of the graduates, Ms. Annico will hand out the certificates, and Father John Hebert will hand out the silver crosses.
Benjamin Agavis, Ontario Scholar. Noah Algieri, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Aiden Almeida. Olivia Anderson, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Philosophy. Brianna Andre, Olivia Andre, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Dance, Extracurricular Writing. Riley Arnold, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Macy Aubin, Ontario Scholar. Anne-Marie Ballard-Skiros, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Riley Potter-Sauvé, Specialist High Skills Major in Information and Communication Technology, Red Seal Diploma, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Ethan Bax, Ontario Scholar. Cole Bears. Suzanne Bassett. Bronwyn Beavis, Ontario Scholar. Jeremiah Beckwith. John Gwynn Timothy, Certificate of Accomplishment. Dylan Beltrami, Ontario Scholar. Owen Best, Ontario Scholar. Ella Best Taylor, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Matter. Michael Biss, Ontario Scholar. Caden Boisvert, Ontario Scholar. Luke Moriotis. Andrew Bodding. Sarah Brady, Extracurricular Letter. Amy Brio. Abigail Brooke, Ontario Scholar. Xander Brown. Xander Burrows, Specialist High Skills Major in Information and Communication Technology, Red Seal Diploma. Jake Byers. Ethan Carlo, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Construction Technology. Daniel Carroll. Gracie Caverly, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter. Alexander Circelli. Jackson Clancy. Peyton Clark. Olivia Clement, Ontario Scholar. Andrew Costa, Ontario Scholar, Extracurricular Letter. Sophia Crockett. Peyton De Silva, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Computer Engineering and Computer Science. Jack Descartes. Scotia Daniels. Bryson Day, Ontario Scholar, Extracurricular Letter. Diego Frias. Aiden Niveau, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Philosophy. Justin Docanto. Drew Donaldson. Devin Doucette, Ontario Scholar. Paige Douglas. Ethan Dowden. Ella Doyle McLaughlin, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Extracurricular Letter. Emily Droulard. Sophie Nugelstein, Ontario Scholar. Declan Dupel, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Claudia Einerson, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter. Charlie Enright, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Riker Erb, Ontario Scholar. Katie Everson, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Subject Award in Economics, English, and Religion, Extracurricular Letter. Caitlin Ewart, Ontario Scholar. Dahlia Ferguson. Alessia Finos, Ontario Scholar. Sierra Fitzgerald, Crusader Certificate. Abigail Fox, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Subject Award in Religion. Sierra Francis Griffin. Taylor Franco, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Subject Award in Woodwinds, Music, and Communications Technology. Cameron Gallagher, Ontario Scholar. Avery Gallagher, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Extracurricular Letter. Dylan Garrison, Subject Award in Healthy Living Education. Aidan Goodett, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Extracurricular Letter. Spencer Goodett, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter. Evan Gibson, Ontario Scholar. Anna Goddard, Ontario Scholar. Zachary Gora, Ontario Scholar. Dylan Graham, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Healthy Living Education. Melia Rand. Yet Harmon, Subject Award in Mathematics. Jonah Hamilton, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French.
We will continue with graduating teacher, Ms. Carrie, graduating teacher, Mr. Patrick Pryor, will now read the names of the graduates. Ms. Terry Daniel will hand out the certificates, and Mr. Nick Cotman will hand out the silver crosses.
Kevin Hamilton. David Aquila, Crusader Certificate. Beatrice Hedke, Ontario Scholar, Extracurricular Letter. Zoe Hayes, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Subject Award in Chemistry and World History, Extracurricular Letter. Aaliyah Pinch, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Patrick Pinch, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Kelly Hoang, Ontario Scholar. Roland Hull. Olivia Boodle, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter. Bradley Halton. Lillian Humphrey, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter. Noah Hunter, Ontario Scholar. Charlie Jock, Ontario Scholar. Ineska Havier, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Subject Award in Law, Extracurricular Letter. Haley Jeffrey. Josiah Jeffs, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Shaylin Johnson, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Drama and Vocals, Extracurricular Letter. Antoine Jolicoeur, Ontario Scholar. Madison Joyce, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Families in Canada, Subject Award in Nutritional Health. Sarah Justinico, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Caitlin Kelly, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Davina Kelvin, Ontario Scholar. Elizabeth Kerr. Owen Kinney, Ontario Scholar. Martha LaPont Brady, Ontario Scholar, Extracurricular Letter. Mateo Laredo. Rihanna Lawrence, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Colby Lieber. Jacob LeBlanc, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Sports Leadership, Extracurricular Letter. Alyssa LeClaire, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Liam Legacy, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Faith Leggett, Specialist High Skills Major in Information and Communication Technology, Red Seal Diploma. Priya Lodi, Ontario Scholar. Owen MacArthur, Ontario Scholar. Lisa McDonald, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Ian McDonald, Ontario Scholar. Louisa Macedo, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Julia May, Ontario Scholar. Danica Christine Marcello, Crusader Certificate. Dea Angela Marcello. Tara Martin, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Extracurricular Letter. Nathan Matos, Ontario Scholar. Kennedy Matos Bell, Ontario Scholar. Sarah Matthews, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Subject Award in English, French, Human Development, Functions, Calculus, and State Band. And Extracurricular Letter. Karen McAllister, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Computer Engineering, Extracurricular Letter. Luca McCullough, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Biology, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Subject Award in Winwind's Music, Extracurricular Letter. Liam McFarland, Ontario Scholar. Adam McKinley, Ontario Scholar. Reese McShane. Caden Montagnier Holder, Ontario Scholar. Emma Morin Gravel, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Casey Morton, Ontario Scholar. Jessica Mossrock, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Outdoor Education. Marissa Buccicito, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Yearbook. Kayla Murphy, Ontario Scholar. Caleb Murray, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Andreas Neopoulos, Ontario Scholar. Nicholas Newman. Sophia Nikitopoulos, Ontario Scholar, Extracurricular Dietary. Adam Nuttall, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Subject Award and Student Council, Extracurricular Dietary. Kira O'Donoghue, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Dietary. Wyatt Pottenhoff. Raylan O. Anthony Overvell, Ontario Scholar.
Bronwyn Pyle, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Subject Award in Religion, Extracurricular Letter. David Parsons, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Kara Posh, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Jack Pascal, Ontario Scholar. Mia Pengelly, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in World Issues, Extracurricular Letter. Hannah Pennell, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Michaela Penny, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Subject Award in Cooperative Education and Mathematics, Extracurricular Letter. Paige Perrin. Max Failey. Josie Pickstock, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Subject Award in Religion. Emiliano Pimentel, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Extracurricular Letter. Santiago Pimentel, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter. Anna Polycan, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter. Jillian Pond, Chase Price, Specialist High Skills Major in Information and Communication Technology, Red Seal Diploma, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter. April Prozonka, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Samara Ron, Ontario Scholar. Stephanie Rand, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter. Abigail Renault, Certificate, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter. Jonah Reynolds, Ontario Scholar. Leonard Rink, Ontario Scholar. Zoe Rohrbeck, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Extracurricular Letter. Angus Rowe, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter.
Crusader Michelli, Ontario Scholar. Murillo Salas de Oliveira, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Owen Salmon, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Jacob Sanford. Grace Schulman, Ontario Scholar. Callie Snurge, Ontario Scholar. Andre Scoville. Zoe Shorty, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Mathematics. Raya Sidhu, Crusader Certificate. Kylie Smith. Natalie Snyder. Tyson Snyder. Avery Soares, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Eric Sonneman, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Religion, Extracurricular Letter. Bradley St. Pierre, Ontario Scholar. Curtis Stacey, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Lucas Stevens. Luigi Stuber. Ryan Sullivan, Crusader Certificate. Seth Sidwick. Brock Sikowski, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Technological Design. Parisa Tahamatan, Crusader Certificate, recipient of the Work Pool Student Bursary, Extracurricular Letter. Carson Thibault, Ontario Scholar. Trinity Fitzgerald, Sean Thompson, Certificate of Proficiency in French. I'm sorry, Chelsea. Chelsea Thompson, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Nathaniel Tinkus, got it. Madeline Toss, Extracurricular Letter, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Writer's Craft and Visual Arts. Ethan Tron, Ontario Scholar. Madeline Trotter. Claire Venner, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Subject Award of Religion, Extracurricular Letter. Harmony Van Schindel, Ontario Scholar. Derek Van Dale, Crusader Certificate. Kate Vanderlyn, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Woodwinds Music, Extracurricular Letter. Eddie Van Dyke, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter. Maya Volante. Peyton Walsh, Ontario Scholar. Ian Watts, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate. Bradley Webb, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Manufacturing Technology, Extracurricular Letter. Nolan Wem. Liam Whalen, Ontario Scholar.
Trinity Whalen, Sierra Wan, Ontario Scholar, Andrew White, Bowden White, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Accounting, Crusader Certificate, Extracurricular Letter. Nicholas White, Anna Williams, Ontario Scholar, Janessa Williams, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Yearbook. Lauren Wilson, Ontario Scholar, Certificate of Proficiency in French, Subject Award in Woodwinds Music. Lauren Wilson, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Transportation Technology. Jessica Witches, Ontario Scholar, Crusader Certificate, Certificate of Proficiency in French. Devin Woodcock, Subject Award in Healthy Living Education. Jacob Woods, Ontario Scholar. Amin Worrell, Ontario Scholar. Jack Wyatt, Ontario Scholar, Subject Award in Custom Woodworking. Jackson Young. Trinity Fitzgerald.
Instead, you are now a Holy Cross graduate. As a sign of this transition, please move your tassel from the left side of your cap to the right. Ladies and gentlemen, the graduating class of 2020.
Opportunity, even though we were kind of all untold. Some of you may be asking, what exactly is a class rep? And to be quite honest, we were wondering the same thing. One of our jobs is to keep in contact with all of you for future reunions, which shouldn't be a problem since I'm sure Most of you will still be living with your parents in 20 years.
So, as mentioned previously, my name is Shaylin, but there is a really good chance that most of you guys know me as Shaggy, so we're going to go with that. Our other job as a class rep is to decide on a gift to the school that we can leave our mark on that will also impact future generations. We considered many options. One of the good ones was trying to be heroes and do a do-it-yourself bagel stand. Then we realized that, you know, since we don't count cases anymore, COVID's basically disappeared and the cafeteria will be back next year. So that stand means nothing. Then there was the idea to scrap the football field and put in a splash pad. We realized we don't have the money for that, and some people might have been upset. Speaking of out of the budget, we thought of one of those phone charger lockers, you know, the ones that they have at the care center. But then we realized that the odds of any of the future students leaving their phones somewhere where they're not for longer than 5 minutes is extremely uncommon, slim to none. However, out of all the options that we did try, my favorite one was firing Mr. Orser so that no more grade 9 band kids would have to suffer. Apparently, being a class rep doesn't give us the authority to fire teachers, but, I'm kidding, Mr. Orser, if you're listening, by the way. No? Okay, cool. Awesome.
So after careful consideration, and obviously all of our other ideas were rejected, we decided to replace the outdated crash mats on either end of this large gym, and we hope to have a student create a design for one of the mats and to leave the other one blank to create space for any future changes that may come to Holy Cross. Both mats will also have Class of 2022 written somewhere on them, and we feel as though the gym is a place where Holy Cross's community is truly brought together and celebrated, and therefore our gift will be seen at every future mass, sports game, and by every future graduate to walk across the stage as we are today.
As far as the class reunion idea goes, we're still working on a social platform to use. We were thinking about doing emails, but then we realized that once we get to the real world, a lot of your guys' emails are gonna have to change from NoahFootball21 and PowerpuffGirl78. However, if we do end up keeping in contact with all of you, we're hoping to hold the reunion on this day in 22 years since we're the class of 2022. Thank you guys for letting us waste a couple minutes of your lives, and we hope that you all enjoyed the night so far. Congratulations on all your hard work, and good luck to everyone in all that they pursue. See you in 2044.
Good evening. We now move to the awards portion of the evening. There are 41 in total. Each award winner was selected by a committee of administrators, teachers, sponsors, and support staff with input from the entire staff team who worked tireless to match graduates with the criteria for the award. To give the recipients the recognition they deserve, I will read the award name, the presenter, and the award winner. As the winner comes forward, I will read the criteria for the selection of the award. After the graduate has received the award, we will acknowledge the recipient with applause, during which time the award winner and presenter will stop on stage here for a photo before heading back to their seats. All of these photos will be emailed to you using a shared drive. Some awards have larger plaques, which you will hand off to Mrs. Lesarge here on the left after taking your photo. These larger plaques stay at the school. Mr. Rick White will present the Scotty Memorial Scholarship to Jeremiah Beckwith. This award is presenting a memory of Scott Legg to a graduate who demonstrates Scotty's traits and values. Having a positive attitude, being empathetic, protective, confident, energetic, athletic, and community. Mrs. Marie Hulse will now present the Barb Storing Memorial Scholarship to Andy Costa. This is presented to a graduate who has shown great strength of character and self-advocacy in overcoming challenges to achieve academic success, and who has contributed to the positive and inclusive culture at Holy Cross.
The Nick Reed Memorial Visual Arts Award will be presented by Mr. Jose Lobo to Maddie Toffs and Alicia Fina. This is presented to the graduating students who have demonstrated artistic excellence, promoted the visual arts in the school and community, and will pursue post-secondary studies in art and art-related studies at the university and college levels. Mr. Nick Cotman will present the Catholic Student Award to Zoe Rohrbeck. This award, sponsored by the Catholic Education Foundation of Ontario, was presented to the student who embraces and enhances the Catholic identity of Holy Cross in the local community. Mr. Matt Gervais will present the Gordon F. Tompkins Memorial Bursary to Claire Van Erd. This award is presented to a graduating student planning to further studies towards a career in funeral services or in palliative care, nursing, or medical studies. The Holy Cross Yearbook Award will be presented by Ms. Nadia Burnaby to Marissa, she helped me say this, Mucha Chido. This is presented to a graduating student who has made significant contributions to the school yearbook. Mr. Ted Daniel will now present the Crusader Award to Trinity Fitzgerald and John Gwynn Timothy. This award is presented to graduating students who exemplify enthusiasm for your life. School Board Trustee Mrs. Kathy Turkington will present the School Council Award to Jack White. This award is presented to a graduate who intends to pursue studies in college and who, in the opinion of the Holy Cross staff, has contributed significantly to school spirit and to our community. Mr. Pat Healy will present the OYAP Award of Excellence in Apprenticeship to Nick Newman and Zachary Gora. This award is presented to a graduating student for demonstrating outstanding ability in an apprenticeship program. Knights of Columbus Grand Knight, Mr. Michael Lombarquette, will present the Knights of Columbus Award to Pereza Tomatan and Santiago Pimentel. This award is presented in memory of Art Arsenal to male and female students who best exemplify Christian values through service to the church, the school, or the community, who will pursue post-secondary studies. Ms. Shannon Perugino will now present the Ontario English Catholic Teachers Association scholarships to Avery Suarez and Michaela Penny. This is presented to students who are enrolled in a college program that will lead to a career working with youth, and to a student who has been accepted to the first year of a concurrent education degree program. The Back Home Family Award of Recognition will be presented by Mr. Dan Roberts to Beatrice Heckey. This award is presented to a graduating student pursuing post-secondary education. The Holy Cross Technical Award will be presented by Mr. Pat Healy to Peyton Da Silva. This award is presented to a graduating student from a technical course intending to enter an apprenticeship or college program. Holy Cross Vice Principal Mrs. Anna Koh will present the Lieutenant Governor's Community Volunteer Award to April Prozanka. To a graduating student for exemplary involvement in our community. The Holy Cross Associate Teachers Award will be presented by Mr. Tim Pendergast to Anne-Marie Ballesteros, Anesca Javier, Bowden White, Lauren Wilson with an E, and Evan Gibson. This award is presented to graduating students who have excelled in more than one course in any department. Mrs. Jennifer McDonald will present the Holy Cross Apollo Award for Excellence in Audio and Visual Production to Jonah Hamilton. This is presented to a graduating student who will pursue university studies and who has demonstrated during his or her high school career creativity, technical innovation, and leadership to staff and students in the area of audio and video production. The Holy Cross HCTV Award for Excellence in Audio and Video Production, presented again by Mrs. Jennifer McDonald, to Josie Pickstock. This is presented to a graduating student who will pursue college studies and who has demonstrated during her high school career creativity, technical innovation, and leadership to staff and students in the area of audio and video production. School Board Trustee Mrs. Kathy Turkington will present the St. Lawrence Governor's Entrance Scholarship to Madison Joyce. This entrance scholarship is awarded to a graduate on the basis of academic achievement, special achievement, and citizenship. The Kingston Frontenac Rotary Club Award will be presented by Mrs. Jenny Mello Jordan to Eddie Van Dyke. This award is presented to a graduating student who has demonstrated involvement in community leadership and civic responsibility through participation in their community, either locally or internationally. The Greg Hulse Award will be presented by Mrs. Marie Hulse to Martha LaPlante Brady. This is presented to a student who displays determination, drive, compassion, and the ability to perform to the highest level in any sporting, academic, community, or arts endeavor. Mrs. Kathy Turkington will present the Joseph H. Duffy Award to Lisa McDonald. This is presented to a female graduate pursuing post-education at a community college. Ms. Terry Daniel will present the Principal's International Student Recognition Award to Jet Harmon. This is presented to the international graduate who has demonstrated academic excellence and has shown leadership in the international student group and larger student population. Holy Cross Vice Principal Mrs. Anna Coe will present the Holy Cross Secondary School Award for Excellence to Adam McKinley, Olivia Andre, Nathan Matos, Anna Williams, Stephanie Rand, and Jacob LeBlanc. This award is presented to graduating students who demonstrate academic ability and a sense of school spirit. Stacy Check Drum will present the McCarthy Theater Award to Shaylin Johnston. This is presented to an individual who has made significant contributions to the theater program at Holy Cross for 4 years. Mrs. Joanne Van Esch will present the Charles C. Jeffries Engineering Award to Zoe Hayes. This is presented to a graduate who is pursuing a degree or diploma program in a branch of engineering and who, in the opinion of the school staff, exemplifies the qualities of a Catholic student. Mr. Peter Renault will present the Engineers of Kingston Bursary to Kieran McAllister. Presented to a graduating student who has demonstrated academic excellence and who has been accepted to the first year of an engineering program. The Sullivan Construction Bursary will be presented by Mrs. Elizabeth Mulvena to Kate Vanderlyn. A student enrolled in a post-secondary program at a college or university in construction, engineering, or a business-related program. Mr. Dan Dusson will present the Sullivan Construction Trades Bursary to Lauren Wilson with a Y. This is presented to a student enrolled in a labor or trades-related apprenticeship program. Mr. Nick Cotman will present the Crusaders in Community Service Spirit Award to Tara Martin and Ian Watts. This is presented to a graduating student in recognition of his or her contributions to KICS and his or her service to the school community. The Archdiocese of Kingston Award will be presented by Nick Cobman to Spencer Gaudet. This is presented to graduates for significant contributions to the faith element of the church and school community. Superintendent of Education, Mrs. Carrie Smith Dewey, will present the Director of Education Award for Achievement to Adam Nuttall. This is presented to a graduating student for a significant achievement in the school community. The Wilkinson and Company LLP Scholarship will be presented by Mrs. Karen Nickel to Caitlin Kelly. This is presented to a graduate who has demonstrated academic excellence and who is pursuing business studies. The Holy Cross Citizenship Award will be presented by Mr. John Drum to Jacob Woods and Eric Sonneman. Graduating student who has demonstrated a commitment to work ethic, community spirit, personal excellence, and Catholic values. Mrs. Anna Coe will present the Sister Marian McCallum Bursary to Taylor Franco. Presented to a graduating student who exemplifies the qualities of a Catholic student and who will pursue post-secondary studies at university in music, religion, or languages. Patrick V. Slack Language Bursary will be presented by Mrs. Kristen Check to Declan Duhel. Presented to a graduate who exemplifies the qualities of a Catholic student and who has excelled in a second language program. Mrs. Gloria Bella Bowery will present the St. George Preca Award to Riker Erb. This award is presented in memory of Tony Vella to a graduating student who intends to pursue a trade and who has given significantly to his or her community. Mr. Trevor Weir will present the Carol A. Weir Award to Sarah Matthews. Presented to a graduate who is enrolled in a concurrent education program and who exemplifies the qualities of a Catholic student. Ms. Jamie Hollins will present the Mark Erickson Environmental Award to Santiago Pimentel. Who has worked passionately to advocate and take action on environmental issues in the Kingston area. Holy Cross Vice Principal Mr. Dan Finn will present the Holy Cross Medal of Merit to Jack Wyatt. This is presented to the graduating student with the highest average studying at the college level. Holy Cross Principal Ms. Terry Daniel will present the Stanley A. Sobel Awards. These are presented to the four graduating students with the highest marks in grade 12 at the U or M level. Please come forward, Sarah Matthews, Katie Everson, Luca McCullough, and Zoe Hayes. Governor General's Bronze Medal.
I'll have to stay here. I'll have to stay here. Okay, get back.
So, the Governor General's Bronze Medal is presented to the graduating student with the highest average, all grade 11 and 12 courses on their transcript. Please step forward, Sarah Matthews. Congratulations to all awards recipients. I would now like to call to the podium your valedictorian, Luca McCullough.
Members of the board, administration, faculty, staff, parents and family, and of course, the graduates. Today, I have the special honor of reflecting on the shared experiences of our graduating class. I think it is safe to say we've had the most interesting 4 years of high school. So thank you everyone for this opportunity to be together, to celebrate one another. As you know, our theme this year is Beloved Children of God. To me, this means seeing the blessings in our lives and recognizing that, although it may feel like we're getting pretty old now, we are all still constantly learning and growing. Look at Mr. Orser. Even he's not too old to learn new tricks. If only his jokes were new too. A great deal of the growth we have achieved can be attributed to the amazing staff who may code across the school it is. I'm sure everyone can think of at least one staff member who has encouraged them to be a better version of themselves, whether that be in studying, playing a sport, or life in general. Personally, I did not expect to be so impacted by everyone here. You have all played crucial roles in our lives during our time at this school. May I take this time to thank each of you on behalf of the graduating class. And to my fellow graduates, accept this challenge. Try to take the time to say your personal thank yous, as I know will be appreciated. Our given and our chosen family, along with our friends, have also been blessings to this graduating class, supporting us in our academics, our extracurriculars, and our everyday life. Many of you here and watching from home have helped us with homework, driving lessons, and the infinite hardships of being a teen. From guardians to siblings and to close friends, you really are role models for the young adults we are becoming. So thank you. You have all helped us to reach this moment. My hope is, as we graduate, this growth continues, and that we also become more self-sufficient. I really don't want to still be in my room when I'm 30, but no promises. The final, and perhaps most important blessing I see today, is you, my fellow graduates. I must say that I did not feel like the right person to represent us all. Aside from my brief career as a Holy Cross athlete, I spent more time studying in my room than joining teams or clubs or going to events, so I'm by no means a school mascot. You know, though, I probably could have been the senior team quarterback or the lead in the play, but COVID. However, when I think back to the start of grade 9 and how scared I was to enter such a big school community that I didn't know much about, I also think of everyone else who felt just as nervous trying to find their first class or make new friends or steer clear of the older kids in the hall. I think of us getting mutually doused in paint on orientation day and cheering for each other at first tournaments and art shows and award ceremonies. Wow, that was our last full year of normal high school. Then came grade 10 with how uncertain everything felt with the lockdowns and COVID cases, the heightened sense of anxiety and trepidation. I am reminded of how we all had to navigate learning from home and how some of us pretended our microphones didn't work during class. That was a tough year for everyone, but at least our marks came with them. When I reflect on grade 11, it was like, go to class, go home. Not what we hope or expect from a school like Holy Cross. I remember us still struggling to find new normals amidst the pandemic, and unfortunately, having to mourn the loss of our friend Scotty. But this past year, I also remember that we got back into arts and sports and all the things that made us enjoy school in the first place. I saw the community of Holy Cross begin to bloom once again. When I look out at all of you seated here today, I know that I'm among the strongest group of people. Who else could better understand each other's fears, but also the excitement of what the future may hold? So, as we all follow our own paths from here to colleges, universities, jobs, or even returning for another round of grade 12, I encourage you all to carry with you the memories we have made here and the lessons we have learned in our time together. Know that your experiences at Holy Cross, good or bad, have better prepared you for what lies ahead. And if you ever feel alone, think of your classmates sitting around you right now, and know that they are facing this new stage of life right alongside you. Some of us have known each other since we were four, and some of us haven't even met yet. But our time at Holy Cross has given us a unique, shared perspective of life. Although it feels like just yesterday we were walking into the school for the first time, I know that each of us is leaving as a stronger and wiser individual. To close, I want to again thank everyone who has helped us reach this moment. You have expanded our hearts and our minds, and I think everything from our high school experience will stick with us for the rest of our lives. To my classmates specifically, congratulations on making it here, and good luck on your continued adventures. Thank you.
Mr. Dan Roberts to present tokens of appreciation to our salutatorian and Val. Attention to the screen for a video presentation by Ms. Jen Nall.
So the- goes by the front door. Don't forget the keys under the mat. When childhood stars shine, always stay humble and kind. Go to church 'cause your mama says to. Visit grandpa every chance that you can. It won't be wasted time. Always stay humble and kind. Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, don't lie. I know you got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. When the dreams you're dreaming come to you, when the work you put in is realized, let yourself feel the pride, but always stay humble and kind. Don't expect a free ride from no one. Don't hold a grudge or a chip, and here's why. Bitterness keeps you from flying. Always stay humble and kind. Know the difference between sleeping with someone and sleeping with someone you love. I love you ain't no pickup line, so always stay humble and kind. Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, don't lie. I know you got to climb, but always stay humble and kind. When those dreams you're dreaming come to you, when the work you put in is realized, let yourself feel the pride, but always stay humble and popsicle. Shut off the AC and roll the windows down. Let that summer sun shine. Always stay humble and kind. Don't take for granted the love this life gives you. When you get where you're going, don't forget, turn back around. Help the next one in line. Always stay humble and kind.
Custodians, greeters, bouncers, and greeters, the awards committee, and to all others whose tireless effort made tonight happen, we thank you. You know, they say hindsight is 20/20, which if I think about it is not really a phrase that has aged well. However, if we reflect back on the pandemic, there are lessons that can be learned. We learn to appreciate the things in your life that you take for granted, like toilet paper and hand soap. We learn that people do not like being told what to do, even if it has the potential to save their lives. That if given the opportunity, men prefer to work pantsless. That you touch your face approximately 16 times per hour. That baking bread is therapeutic, and that the ideal time to nap is 2 p.m. Turns out that more time was not what was needed to finally organize your closet, clean out your junk drawer, or start working out.
And after being homebound for a few months, you can finally appreciate why your dog gets so excited and also suspicious when you see someone walk by your house. We also confirmed some things that we were pretty sure we already knew. That self-haircuts are a bad idea, that forced hugs and kisses with your distant relatives are unnecessary, that working outside the home was definitely a good choice, and that homeschooling will never be an option. We also gained perspective. Watching someone blow out their birthday candles will never be the same. In the end, the pandemic gave us the opportunity to slow down and has given us perspective on what is necessary in life. And it turns out that what is necessary has nothing to do with material things, except for the toilet paper. That was necessary. Maybe not as much as we bought, but definitely some was necessary. When faced with a deadly virus, it didn't matter who was better looking, who had more stuff, and who had a better plastic surgery. When faced with losing it all, we learned who and what matters most to us. Good could be seen all around us in the last 2 years. Leaders have learned to trust employees. Businesses have learned how to think differently. Technology has been embraced in new ways. Mental health is finally getting the attention that it needs. The most vulnerable in our society were given a break. People are fighting for conditions for those living in long-term care. Our essential workers were shown appreciation, and people helped their neighbors. We could reflect upon your time in high school and fret about what was lost. There were losses, there's no doubt about that. Or instead, we can choose, all of us, to find and to keep what was great about this hardship that we were forced to endure. I know that this is difficult for some, and we cannot ignore the tragedy that unfolded for many people. We can, however, decide that we can make decisions not based on what is expected of us or what society tries to force upon us, but instead we can live lives based on the kindness and compassion that was modeled by many during the pandemic. We can hold on to the values that we found when the possibility of losing it all became real. Maya Angelou said, "I can be changed by what happens to me, but I refuse to be reduced by it." My greatest wish for all of you as you take your final walk through the halls of Holy Cross this evening is that you take a moment to appreciate the changes that you've gone through in the last 4 years. And when the world gets dark and harsh and scary, you will be able to take what you've learned and realize that you do not need to be reduced by it. The world can be a cruel, selfish, and unfair place. Don't believe the lie that to be successful, you need to be that too. Take what you've learned here and make the world a kinder, sweeter, gentler place. Know that you will always have a home here, you will always be welcome here, and you will always be loved here. Good night, good luck, and may you always stay home.